Hello, checking in from Mike Shea's Coffee. Today I'm roasting some dark Sumatra. We're using a grade one. Nice bean. I typically like mine medium, but hey, you know, some people, the dark side's the way to go. Still gives nice fruity tones, winey, earthy. Same deal. As you can see, it's pretty good quality, some minimal defects, but that's common, especially with this type of process. So right now, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna charge the roaster. What does that mean? That means I'm basically gonna load the coffee in the top hopper. I'm gonna drop it in the roaster and get this going. Hold on a second. This is what it means when you call yourself a small batch roaster. That's 15 pounds I just loaded. I'm gonna get ready, I'm just watching my temp. Everything's calculated with time, temperature. I'm gonna drop it in a second. Just loaded it up in that hopper there. All right, I got some bright lights on so you'll be able to see the coffee through the roasting process. Alright, we got this beast on the road. Let me move you a little closer so you can see. I'll adjust some quality of the light. This video is going to be probably about just under 16 minutes or so. Out as goes through its stages so you can see how it changes. Right now the first couple minutes is pretty much just going through the drying process. Coffee typically has 10 to 12% moisture. When it's being loaded in your roaster, you know, before it's shipped to the warehouses, it typically needs to be a little bit higher. Coffee that's a year older or so loses moisture. Sometimes you get very flat, plain tones in your coffee after it's roasted as crop. So we're about 2 minutes in. Yeah, that's a shout out. Go get some coffee. slowly adjusting the temperature as we go. Yeah, don't touch the metal, it's hot. Out of the cooling bin so you don't get any green coffee inside your roasted coffee. Basically what we're doing is we're creating a profile. Profile curve. We're following the profile curve. I've already created it. That's why you don't see me making too many adjustments to this roast. Not really what you call production, but yeah, I've done this a couple times for this batch. I know exactly how it's going to come out. Every time we get new coffee in, whether it's old or new, you gotta make slight adjustments. Some people ask how you get a taste. Well, you gotta, all about trial and error. Profile. That's basically what we do. We charge from the top where the dot is. Your coffee starts dropping through heat. Charge it at the top. Really hot inside there. You drop it, it's absorbing. Pretty basic, just like cooking anything. Then it goes up as we go. The end point, well, that's up to you to decide. Coloring. Right now we're about almost 8 minutes into the roast. Sumatra is kind of a funny bean, it's not showing you this, but see, color changes. Could be worse. The fun- fun part is really getting the new coffee in and getting to play around with it and seeing how it reacts different with the heat, new airflow, all that fun stuff. All right, we're 9 minutes.
Roasted.
comes out to, so you can really take control of your roast and develop something for your customer. I like medium roast, I like lighter roast, dark roast. Say dark roast takes the flavor away. Kind of agree, but depends who's roasting it and how bad you roast it. Some coffees are terrific dark. So you can hear this thing popping like crazy now, I believe. Let's take a look for about 15 minutes. Back the roast, not the roaster, good luck Mike, that thing's heavy. I'm gonna back the camera up a little bit so you can get the full effect of the beans dropping into the cooling tray. Alright. Ah, fire! No, just kidding. So, don't worry, I got it. Ready. Here we go. Sorry for the bad humor. And then at this point, we're just going to check and smell and see how the coffee is. It's pretty dark. And that's pretty much how we roast coffee here. I hope you enjoyed the video. Hope I didn't offend anybody.